Article 36 of the Family Code or psychological incapacity of one or both spouses shall be legal grounds to declare their marriage void. In these cases, it was granted, but such decree also comes with complete separation or dissolution of properties. Here's what happens in Valdez versus Quezon City RTC. Disclaimer, our videos on laws are based on actual cases. Any details, especially of the plaintiff and the defendant or the accused, offensive in any way, kindly leave a comment or message us in Facebook, and we will be more happy to change any details accordingly. In Valdez versus Quezon City RTC, Antonio Valdez and Consuelo Gomez were married on June 5, 1971. Their union spawned 5 children. In a petition on June 22, 1992, Valdez sought the declaration of nullity of their marriage pursuant to Article 36 of the Family Code, which the Regional Trial Court of Quezon City granted. Consuelo Gomez sought a clarification of the portion of the decision directing compliance with Articles 50, 51, and 52 of the Family Code. She asserted that the Family Code contained no provisions on the procedure for liquidation of common property in unions without marriage. During the hearing of the motion, the children filed a joint affidavit expressing their desire to remain with their father, Antonio Valdez, herein the petitioner. In an order on May 5, 1995, the trial court made the following clarification. Consequently, considering that the Article 147 of the Family Code explicitly provides that the property acquired by both parties during their union, in the absence of proof to the contrary, are presumed to have been obtained through the joint efforts of the parties and will be owned by them in equal shares. Plaintiff and defendant will own their family home and all their respective properties for the matter in equal shares. The petitioner moved to reconsider of the order. The motion was denied on October 30, 1995. Hence, this petition. The issue now is whether or not the Article 147 of the Family Code applies to cases of Article 36. The Supreme Court says yes. The trial court correctly applied the law. In void marriages, regardless of the cause thereof, the property relations of the parties during the period of cohabitation is governed by the provisions of Article 147 or Article 148. Such as the case may be of the Family Code, Article 147 is a remake of Article 144 of the Civil Code as interpreted and so applied in previous cases. If so, it provides. Article 147. When a man and a woman who are capacitated to marry each other live exclusively with each other as husband and wife without the benefit of marriage or under a void marriage, their wages and salaries shall be owned by them in equal shares, and the property acquired by both of them through their work or industry shall be governed by the rules of co-ownership. In the absence of proof to the contrary, properties acquired while they live together shall be presumed to have been obtained by their joint efforts, work, or industry, and shall be owned by them in equal shares. For the purpose of this article, a party who did not participate in the acquisition by the other party of any property shall be deemed to have contributed jointly in the acquisition thereof, if the former's effort consisted in the care and maintenance of the family and of the household. Article 147 of the Family Code in substance and to the above extent has clarified that Article 144 of the Civil Code. In addition, the law now expressly provides that A. Neither party can dispose or encumbered by act inter vivos his or her share in the co-ownership of the property without the consent of the other during the period of cohabitation. And in the case of void marriages, any party in bad faith shall forfeit his or her share in the co-ownership in favor of their common children. In default thereof or waiver by any of the common children, each vacant share shall belong to the respective surviving descendants, or still in default thereof, to the innocent party. The forfeiture shall take place upon the termination of the cohabitation or declaration of nullity of marriage, when the common law spouses suffer from a legal impediment to marry, or when they do not live exclusively with each other as husband and wife. Only the property acquired by both of them through their actual joint contribution of money, property, or industry shall be owned in common, in proportion to the respective contribution. Such contribution and corresponding shares, however, are prima facie presumed to be equal. Share of any party who is married to another shall accrue to the absolute community or conjugal partnership, as the case may be. If so, existing under a valid marriage, if the party who has acted in bad faith is not validly married to another, his or her share shall be forfeited in the manner already thereof expressed. A court which has jurisdiction to declare the nullity of marriage must be deemed likewise clothed with the authority to resolve incidental and consequential matters. Nor did it commit a reversible error in the ruling that the petitioner and private respondents own the family home and all their common property in equal shares, as well as concluding that in the liquidation and partition of the property owned in the common by them, the provisioner of co-ownership under the Civil Code, not Articles 50, 51, and 52, in relations to Article 102 and 129 of the Family Code should aptly prevail. Between common law spouses or spouses of void marriages, the rules on co-ownership subject to the provisions of Article 147 and 148 of the Family Code must apply. It must be stressed that the provisions of Family Code on the family home, i.e., that the provisions found in Title 5, Chapter 2 of the Family Code remain in force and effect regardless of the property of the regime of the spouses.